Learn how to create a typing game with ActivePresenter today. The design ideas of the game include: players can press the button to start the game, read the question and press keys corresponding to letters for the answer within 15 seconds. If a letter is correct, it will be hidden and then shown in the crossword. If a letter is incorrect, there is a shaking effect. After players get full of correct letters, a feedback message will be shown to give further explanation. Otherwise, if the timer runs out, a timer feedback message will appear and let players retry that question. Now, let's get started with three main steps. To start, access the View tab, click Resources, drag and drop all necessary files on your computer into the Resources pane. By doing that, you can quickly insert objects from this pane without opening the folder on your computer many times. Navigate to the Design tab to choose a theme for the entire game. Add a game title and instruction and style them the way you want. To let players start the game, you add a button. In its Interactivity tab, Events and Action section, add the unclick event and highlight object and go forward action. You may wonder why use the unclick event here. That's because when a specific button object is focused, pressing enter or space can trigger its unclick event. Now, you continue making the question slide. Each question slide has independent objects and interactivity. So, the following steps will guide you to create only one question slide in detail. After that, you can create as many question slides as you want similarly. It's so easy to add the question title here. To insert letter images, select one or more images in the Resources pane and drag them onto the canvas. To align letter images quickly, you can use inbuilt alignment tools in the Format tab. After that, give each of them a specific and meaningful name. That will help you a lot when recalling them later. To create a crossword to show the answer, click the drop-down arrow on the container, select Grid Box. Click on the green plus here to add cells for a crossword. Because of the 5 letters of the answer, you need to insert 5 shapes. Note that the more cells your crossword contains, the more shapes you need to insert. After that, navigate to the Properties pane of the Grid Box container in the Container Layout section. Set the number of column to 5. To get 5 square shapes, you can change the exact size of the grid box in the Transform section here. Style them as you wish. Then, if you want to show letters in this crossword, creating a letter state for each shape is the easiest way. Select a shape, navigate to its Interactivity tab, click click the State View button. Click the Edit States button to turn on the editing mode. Add a new state and name it Letter, for example. Edit that state by filling the shape with a letter image. Don't forget to rename that shape. One thing you should bear in mind is the Retain State checkbox here. Let's deselect it, so that the shape will reset to its normal state when players replay that question slide. Do the same for the other shape. To set a time limit, you can insert an animated timer object from the Insert tab. Access its Properties pane, Interactivity tab, Timer section. Uncheck this option, then type the exact time limit for your timer. In this part, you need to use variables, events and actions, and advanced actions to create interactivity for the question. First, you navigate to the Home tab to add variables. In this game, you need to create 6 variables, including one number variable and 5 true or false ones. The number variable is to give a point to each correct letter. Meanwhile, 5 true or false variables correspond to 5 letters of the answer. They will help address the condition for an advanced action to occur. Now, let's create 2 advanced actions. The first advanced action occurs when players press correct letters, so you can name it correct letter. Then, add 4 parameters and their corresponding types like this. In the action section below, add the following actions using these parameters. Place a correct sound when a specific key is pressed. Hide a correct letter in the given list. Show a correct letter in the crossword by changing a shape state. Add 1 point to the number variable created earlier. And lastly, set a true or false variable to be equal to true other than its default false value. By doing this, it prevents the advanced action from occurring when players press a key multiple times. Click Save and continue creating the second advanced action for incorrect letters. You just need to create 2 parameters as follows. Next, add the play audio action to play an incorrect sound when players press a specific key. makes an incorrect letter shake. After all, click Save and Close to close the dialog. Now, you need to insert a keystroke object that helps invoke the pressing function for the game. Just delete default feedback messages if you don't need them. And set its style, no fear and no line, to make it totally transparent. After that, navigate to its Interactivity tab, Events and Actions, delete unnecessary events and actions. Then, add the UnKeyPress event. You need to add 5 advanced action actions that correspond to 5 correct letters of the answers. Besides, add a condition so that the advanced action will only occur once. For instance, the true or false variable W is equal to its default false value. You can copy and paste, then change the parameters for the other correct letters. Continue adding some second advanced action actions for the incorrect letters. Don't forget to set the attempts to infinite so that players can press as many times as they want. Now, to make the timer pause when players collect 4 of the correct letters, you add the pause timer action and the condition like this. Come to the View tab to open the Feedback Master. Here, you can customize the explanation and timeout feedback for the question. Select the blank feedback layer, then add content as normal. In addition, add a continue button allowing players to advance to the next question slide when they press enter. In its events and action section, you set up as follows. You can also change the name of this blank feedback layer if you want. Let's say players will get the timeout feedback once reaching the time limit. You select the timeout feedback layer here and customize it the way you want. In the Events and Action section of the Retry button, in the on-click event, add 3 actions in turn. Highlight the button. Setting the value of AP command history back variable to true means going to the previously visited slide in the navigation history. After that, the go forward one slide action helps players come to the current slide. Once you've done, close the master view. Now, you need to add the show feedback layer action to show the customized explanation feedback. When players get full of fine points, select the timer in its events and action section. Add the on timer complete event and an action that shows the timeout feedback. Now, the game is almost done. One more thing you need to bear in mind is when players revisit a specific question slide, all its taken interactions must be reset. Therefore, add the following actions to the question slide on load event. Before exporting the game, you can preview how it works. Finally, export the game to HTML5, SCORM, or XAPI packages, depending on your need. Hope it will help. Bye for now! Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more useful e-learning content.